after the shift is done, next we're going to do some role maintenance. So human resource role maintenance. So on this page, you'll be able to create some roles like clocking in and out. So same top right, you'll be able to click on create new and create a code. So let's say I this another office staff. Let's click in office. So next, I'll be able to assign this role to my office staff. Right, so you can create multiple roles and assign different roles. All right, now you can key in OT hours, acceptable OT hours. So for example, if my minimum OT in my company is actually 2 hours, so employees who are OTing less than 2 hours will not be considered as OT. And you can even set a max amount as well. So maximum amount of OT. And if you take default rule, meaning that every employees that you assign will automatically be assigned to this role. So this can be useful when you are having employees joining in, or you have multiple groups and all that, you'll be able to choose this way. Next, you have the option to tick no OT is request for OT calculation. This is because we have two methods of calculating OT. One is automated, so based on their shift, if they're supposed to work from 9 to 6, any hours extra from this 9 to 6 will be automatically calculated if I tick on this, meaning that they do not need to have a request. However, if they are required to request, I do not tick this, and employees can use their app or system to apply for OT, meaning that the management must approve for maybe 2 hours of OT for these 2 hours to be calculated as overtime. Alright, next we need to choose our daily default shift. So previously when we set up our shift, we can create multiple types of shift and we can assign different shift for different dates. So if your company has multiple shifts, maybe Monday you work from 9 to 6, on Tuesday you work a different hours, weekend different hours, you can set it for different shifts as well. Now, moving on, we have clocking in method. So with our time attendance system, we actually have a method to ensure that your employees are working where they're supposed to be. So first and foremost, we do have our GPS. So if you have employees who are working in out of the office, let's say he might be working in your outlet, he might be visiting clients, delivering items, you just tick on geolocation and the system will capture their exact location during their clocking in and out. Okay, so that is method one. Method two, you select another column, which is the location needs to be matched with a predefined address. So what this means is that I can key in my office address here. The system will find a pin and place on it. For example, this is my office. When I key in the address, the system will find the location, put a pin on it. And in the pin, we have a radius circle. So this radius circle, you will be able to adjust. So 1 meter or maybe up to 50 meters. So depending on how large is your office, you might have a warehouse, you might have a standard office building, you can adjust it accordingly. Normally, we would recommend something like 20 meters. So employees, when they are clocking in, they need to be in a 20 meter radius of the office building to be able to clock in. So they will not be able to clock in from their home or while they're on the way to office. So the latitude and longitude will automatically be filled in once you key in an address. And finally, you have an additional action. So additional action is you can either take a photo or face verification. So the system has our face recognition, or you take a photo as extra evidence. So select that if you require for this to work. Next, we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So for Wi-Fi, you can actually specify your office Wi-Fi to be a clock in and out device. So the system will actually take your router's SSID and BSSID to ensure that employees are really in the building connected to a specific router or device to be able to clock in. And finally, Bluetooth, similar concept to Wi-Fi. However, you can use portable Bluetooth devices. Very useful if you're in the construction or event roadshows environment. So select whichever you are you require. And if you want a little bit more understanding, you may contact us for more information about that.